dramatic declines in fish populations across the globe. This loss has had detrimental consequences to marine ecosystems as a whole, as well as the fishers and communities that rely on them. One of the best ways to solve this problem is to set up marine protected areas, or MPAs, which are designated areas where fishermen don't fish or there is limited fishing. And when they're well enforced and effective, fish populations can bounce back in the matter of 5 to 10 years. MPAs are a fairly simple concept, but much more complex to design and establish. Some of the challenges that we face are, where do we put them? How do we enforce them properly? How do we get fishers involved and to take ownership over these areas? The first step is to make sure that the correct habitats are protected that will support these species throughout their life cycle. We use genetic mapping to determine how these fish move across these areas. Their DNA will tell us how these fish move as adults, how they move as juveniles. We then connect with the communities, since they are instrumental and so important to the success of these areas.
So previously, there was very little data or no data going to managers about their fisheries. Daily transactions normally went on notebooks on paper that would then get lost. Now what we're doing is using an app through a smartphone that will allow us to collect that information directly from the fisher. The app itself is very, very simple. We use icons rather than words, and this takes away a language barrier so that the app can be used anywhere. The fish is brought in and you press that icon on the app. We know which fisher it was and what they were catching, and that allows that information to go to the fisher, fish buyers and local managers, and back to scientists as well to help with the process of monitoring marine protected areas and monitoring fisheries in general. There's been immense amount of interest in the app. Fishers are on board, they're interested to know what they're catching and are they making money, which fisheries are doing well for them, which fisheries aren't. And that's hugely beneficial because that's the first time they've ever been able to do that. The engagement in the app is getting bigger and bigger. Within Honduras and Belize, we have over 2,000 fishers licensed in both countries.
Approximately 90% of the world's fishers are small-scale fishers, and our approach and system is designed specifically for them. So the impact could be huge, and that can take us global because we can apply it really anywhere.
The collaborative nature of this project is giving a real ownership, not just to individuals, but to whole communities. Protecting their own resources and improving their fisheries is very, very important.
This is a huge win-win for both conservation and the local communities. I'm very excited about the potential to improve those communities' livelihoods and to impact their lives in a positive way.